Hi, I'm Nate Story, the co-founder here at Bright Agritech, and today we're going to talk about stocking densities. So, if you have questions about stocking density, you're not alone. There's a lot of folks out there that contact us saying, how many fish should I have in my system? How many fish do I need to put in my tanks? How many fish per gallons of water? And they try, because they think it's this really simple ratio thing. You should always have this many fish for this many gallons. But it really just depends on how much biofiltration is in your system and depends on what you're trying to do with your system. So now, I do recommend around 1 pound of fish per 8 to 10 gallons of water once your fish are fully grown out, okay? So that means, that doesn't mean as soon as you're done cycling, you go and you throw 1 pound of fish in per 10 gallons of water. That means you stock at a ratio that's less than that, but you know your fish are gonna grow to, say, 1 pound size, and you're gonna have one fish, 1 pound, per 8 to 10 gallons of water. So once you kind of have that ratio, you can feed more or you can feed less to get the kind of water conditions you want, whether that's nitrate or pH or whatever. But that's generally what you want to try and start with. It's going to make your life a lot easier than going with some heavier stocking density. A lot of people are going to talk about how, you know, in a 285-gallon IBC, you can grow out 50 pounds of fish or 100 pounds of fish. Yes, you could if you were a commercial aquaculturalist and if you had oxygen injection and all this other fancy equipment that you don't have. So for simple aquaponic systems, think about 1 pound per 8 to 10 gallons, and you're just going to vary then your feed rates to get what you want out of the system. When you go with a lower ratio like that, you're able to do circulation-based aeration. So instead of buying air pumps and all sorts of other fancy stuff to keep your dissolved oxygen high in your system, there's few enough fish in there that just gas exchange with the air and water from your circulatory system, from your pump, can fully aerate your tank. And that's really important if you're trying to save money and just get a very simple, fail-safe system that will operate under any conditions and with a broad host of problems. So that's what I recommend. And you can play with higher and lower stocking densities. Again, it's not a huge deal. It just makes it easier on you to have lower densities and higher oxygen and then vary your feeding rates. So that's just a real brief introduction to stocking densities. If you guys have any other questions, feel free to post them below. Check out our other videos and check out some of our other offerings here on YouTube and also on our website. All right, so this is our greenhouse here. We just came in through the front door and this is kind of looking